Curtis.
Next up is someone else you can throw into the Aaron and Ian rap battle.
Me?
No, Carrie. Not you. Well, yes, but no.
Oh, so you mean Francis?
Yes, here's Francis with a freestyle performance.
Bust it. For all the fellas trying to do what those ladies tell us, get shot down cause you're overzealous, play hard to get females, get jealous. Okay smarty, go to a party, girls are scantily clad and showing body. Chicks walk by and you wish you could sex it, but you're standing on the wall like you was pointing. Next day's function, high class function, food is served and y'all stone cold munching. Music comes on, people start to dance, then ate so much and you split your pants. A girl starts walking, guy starts walking, sits down next to you and starts talking. Says she wants to dance but she likes to groove. Now come on fatso, just bust the move. On a mission, and you're wishing someone could cure your lonely condition. Looking for love in all the wrong places, no fine girls, just ugly faces. From frustration, first inclination is to become a monk and leave the situation. Every dog tunnel has a light of hope, so don't hang yourself with a subbing rope. Your movie's showing, so you're going. Could care less about the five you're blowing. Did a good start, start the show, and then you spot a fine woman sitting in your row. She's dressed in yellow, she says hello, come sit next to me, you fine fella. You run over there without a second to lose, and what comes next, hey, bust the move. Just bust the move. In this city, ladies look pretty. Guys sell jokes so they can seem witty. Have the funny joke just to get some play, and then you try to make a move and she says no way. Girls are faking, goodness sakin', they want a man who brings home the bacon. Got no money and you got no car, and then you got no woman. There you are. Some girls are sadistic, materialistic. Looking for a man makes them opportunistic. And lying on the beach perpetrating a tan, said a brother with money can be their man. On the beach you're strolling, real high rolling. Everything you have is yours and not stolen. Girl grows up with something to prove, so don't just stand there and just bust the move.
If you want it, you got it. You want it, baby, you
just bust the move.
If you want it, you got it. You want it, baby, you
break it down for me, ladies. Has a brother Larry, in 5 days from now he's gonna marry. Just hoping you can make it there if you can, cause in the ceremony you'll be the best man. You say neato, check your libido, roll to the church in a new tuxedo. The bride walks down to start the wedding, and there's one more girl you won't be getting. You start thinking and you start blinking, a bridesmaid looks and thinks that you're winking. Thinks you're kinda cute so she winks back, and then it's feeling really fine cause the girl is deaf. Reception's jumping, faces bumping, look at the girl and your heart starts thumping. Said she wants to dance to a different group. Now you know what to do, she bust the move.
If you want it, you got it. You want it, baby, you got it. You want it, you got it. You want it, baby, you got it.
Well, that was interesting.
Carrie, what's your favorite holiday?
I don't know. Thanksgiving?
Well, you might change your mind after this next one. Here's Joey Volante to spread some Christmas cheer.
Woo! What a bright time, it's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a swell time to go riding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and mingle and jingle your feet. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell rock.
Happen. It is not gonna happen.
All right, well, fine. But you know what they say? The best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
Or wearing costumes like that. Guys, we are single in case you were wondering.
Well, as we go get their numbers backstage, be sure to check out our concession stand during the intermission.
We'll be back in 20 to reveal the top five.
That was good. The mic's good.
Yeah, one of them. Welcome back to the second half of the show.
Can all the contestants please come back onto the stage? Can all the contestants please come back onto the stage? Come on. Hang on, they're coming.
They're a little shy.
They're fashionably late.
But they're here.
That's all that matters. Come on, guys. Come on. There's 14 of you.
Mama boys, the chance to thank their moms for all of their support.
Time to announce the top six. There's a tie for the final spot. In no particular order,
Kobe Allen.
Ben Chronister.
Nick Oz. Joey Vellante.
That was only five.
We need one more.
How would you describe your experience at Norristown Area High School?
It's been a circus, like my mom. It's been a crazy ride, and I've really enjoyed my 4 years here, and I think I've taken advantage of it in a great way. So thank you, everyone.
Why did you want to be a part of Mr. Norristown?
I wanted to be a part of Mr. Norristown because I've heard great things about it, that you form great bonds with people, you have a lot of fun, which I have had a lot of fun during this time. And just all of this has just been fantastic.
What are you going to miss most about Norristown next year?
I'm definitely going to miss all the diversity, most of my friends, definitely. Just going to miss the general Norristown experience that everybody usually looks down upon.
Why do you believe you should win Mr. Norristown?
I believe I should win Mr. Norristown because I love this town. I believe in this town. I grew up in this town. I was born and raised in this town. You know, there's some great people in this town. There's some great history in this town. And, you know, I believe we could get it all back if we just believe and we just keep trying. And I believe I should win Mr. Norristown because I represent Norristown. I have a lot of heart. I'm smart and I'm funny. I'm awesome.
When do you think a boy becomes a man?
Oof. Norristown, well, their freshman year's homecoming dance. It's an interesting ride at first, but I gotta say, I don't know. I just don't know.
How do you believe you've made an impact here at Norristown?
Well, I've done a lot of great things at the school. I love every moment I've been in this school, and I feel I've just left my mark along with these other great people and the other great men in the back, and I'm very proud to be a Norristown alumni.
All right, now for round two. What's your favorite part about Norristown High?
Well, my favorite part is definitely all the fun I've had on cross-country track, and especially with my JROTC peeps out there. I've had great experiences with everyone here, and again, I'm just really proud that I went to Norristown Area High School.
Who has helped you the most during your time at Norristown?
I would have to say my friends and definitely the staff. The staff doesn't stop like encouraging students to do better, and my friends help me when I most need it.
What is your favorite memory from your 4 years here at Norristown?
Favorite memory here. There's so many memories. I can't pick one, but if I would pick one memory, it would be that one win from last year. That would be my favorite memory, man. Oh, man, I love it.
Good answer. Describe your experience at Norristown in one word and why.
One word.
Yes.
I would have to go with amazing. I made a lot of friends. I've had tons of experiences, opened up a lot of doors, a lot of opportunities. Didn't take all of them, regrettably. But yeah, amazing.
How would you describe your Mr. Norristown journey?
Scrumptious. Yeah.
All right.
What is your favorite part about Norristown High?
I want to say staff, but I feel like that's confining it a little, or broadening it, rather. I think the guidance counselors at the school aren't really underrepresented, and I think the guidance counselors do a great job of guiding our students into the future of being really great Norristown alumni.
All right, now back to Carrie and Breezy.
Wow, Carrie, they had some pretty good answers.
They sure did. I was impressed.
These judges sure have a tough decision to make.
To give them some time to deliberate, let's take a look at the making of this year's Mr. Norristown production.